What do you mean by a dipole?
Pair of equal and opposite charges.
Yes, it is how our charges, when it is going to be attracting, what's the field it is going to be creating by when equal and opposite charges are going to be taking place in our any of the silicon diodes, whatever it's going to be, how it is going to be fielding of that. That is about a dipole, means at what distance it's going to be and when it is attracting, what is the field it is going to be creating of that. Yes, that part we taken. Here also the same thing, I just show how a dipole is going to be creating here. Yes, not visible now.
Now it is visible.
Yeah, I didn't share it only. Okay, this is a small example where how a dipole is going to be creating. Observe here. Here, two point charges are there, that is one is negative charge and also about in red color it's of a positive charge. When these two charges are attracted, observe, each charge is having its own electric field, or else its own magnetic field. Yes, this we know. Means, based on these electric charges, the fields, how it is going to be creating, and the field, what it's going to be created by these point charges. By these point charges, observe the how the movement is there, how it is going to be creating its own field, and what is the structure it is changing, that also you observe. Initially the two point charges are separated by distance, after they attracted, how a dipole is creating. Observe here how a field is creating. This is about we call a dipole, the movement what it is going for. That's what we call as a dipole movement in our physics pattern. Now we'll be considering that dipole movement and we'll be deriving the equation for our electric field intensity, how it is going for. Now we'll move on to our topic, that is about the dipole. The dipole, what it is meaning? The same meaning what it's taken. Here also it is going to be the same. An electric dipole, or else a simple dipole, is the name given for two point charges which is having equal magnitude and opposite in sign, means opposite direction, separated by a distance which is very small. If I go with the figure where you can observe here, where our distance is very small. In such applications, you will be getting in a whole surface area. If I am going to consider here as a whole, this, you know, if I take a silicon material, in a silicon there are many positive and negative charges. In this, the field what it is created by two point charges, in the same way the whole how many point charges are there in a material, for those also it is having its own dipole. Here is shown as only two pair of that, that's it, which is a small distance, is very small compared to the distance to the point P. Means the point charges are here. For our consideration, the point P we see somewhere. This is point P. The distance between these two point charges is very less, and distance between for positive charge and negative charge towards the P is again different. The point P at which we want to know the electric and potential fields. That's what we call as a dipole, or else a electric dipole. This is shown in a figure. That's what here it is taken. Here a positive charge is there, here it is a negative charge is there. The separation between these two point charges is a small. That is about, that is here it is taken as D. And the field intensity, or else the potential, what we are going to be considering at the point of P. We are not interested to point know about what is the potential across positive or negative charge. We want to know what is the potential across the point P when a dipole moment is going to be happening between the point charges. That's why we are interested to consider here. That's what here it is taken. Then the distance, a point P is symmetric. What distance we are going to taking from one point charge and a point charge is of a symmetric one. Next, the positive and negative point charges have separation in a Cartesian coordinate system. Here it is taken as the coordinates for two point charges. It's taken as 0, 0, and 1 by 2 d. And for the second one, negative point charge is 0, 0, minus 1 by 2 of d. Means at here it is of half of d, and here it is of half of d. Means xy coordinates is not varying. It is varying with respect to z coordinate system also in a Cartesian coordinate system. This is one figure, how it is taken. Next, the next figure I will go. Before that, we will take the small equation here. To find electric field density, considering two components to keep a track of a spherical coordinate system where our EP is going to be equals to E pi is going to be equals to 0, and then the finding of E, V, potential and also about electric field intensity is by using of the line integral equation. Then after this is the things we already taken of that, now I am going to consider the equation directly here. The line integral gives the potential difference between the two point charges at the end of the integral path. What will you be getting? This equation we already taken, right? That's that equation I'm using here. That is V is going to be equals to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. That is nothing but I can write here as Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into R2. Take the LCM and return here. That's it. We know that Z is going to be equals to 0. Therefore, the midway between the two point charges is the locus of the points where if it is equals to, that is R1 is going to be equals to R2. Some in between of the point charges, we will be taking off that part. One, Z is going to be equals to 0. Or else, and therefore, at the zero potential only. If it is of zero potential, therefore, the all the points are going to be infinity. When it is of zero potential means in the previous cases we learned from infinity point to the to a specified point with a zero potential we will be mentioning the same. Here also taken the same point. Next, for a distance point, R1 is going to be equals to R2. If for some when R1 is going to be equals to R2 in this path. R1 is going to be equals to R2 in such cases. What is it going to be? R1, R2 product is going to be equals to what? If I am taking both the distance of R, then R into R is going to be R square. Therefore, product of the denominator part here in this case, it's going to be replaced. Instead of R1 into R2, I can write here as R square. The approximation may not be made in the numerator. Here we can't do. If it is going to be equals to, where it is equation. If I do in the numerator part, it is going to be 0 only. R1 is equals to R2 means whole part is going to be 0. But numerator we can't consider. But denominator we are going to be considering as a R square. That's it. Without obtaining the trivial answers, this is what's taken. We will taking the that the potential field approaches to 0 when it is when potential is going to be nearly equals to 0 as going on far away from the dipole. Means instead of going to at one point, the distance what it is going to be, it is separating. Here, the separation how it is going to be, it is shown in the figure B. Observe here, at that point, how it is taken, when it is taken in the away, far distance if I am going to be placing. Then observe here to distant point P. Therefore, our R1 is going to be parallel to the R2. And what is the distance of this? It's going to be a R. And what is the separation of what we take? Observe here. This separation is R2 minus R1 is going to be D cos theta. This is what we'll be getting. That's why here it is written the same. That R2 minus R1 is approximated very easily if R1 and R2 are assumed to be a parallel one. Therefore, R2 minus R1 is going to be equals to D cos theta. Therefore, if I substitute in the equation of potential, then I will be getting the equation as V is going to be equals to Q D cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught times r square. This is what we got. Then z is going to be a zero, where theta is going to be 90 degree and at the zero potential. Next, we'll be considering about a gradient. Using gradient relationship between for the spherical coordinate system, E is going to be what? We know this equation in the previously we learnt of this. That is equals to minus del V, that is going to be equals to minus dou V by dou R A R unit vector plus 1 by R dou V by dou theta A theta plus 1 by R sine theta dou V by dou pi A pi. You will be getting. Then we know that we already in the previously we mentioned that our E pi is going to be equals to 0 only. So you will not considering of this part. We left with only of AR and A theta. Therefore, what I'll be getting the equation for AR and A theta is going to be minus of this part of minus Q D cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R cube AR minus for this part Q D sin theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R cube into A theta you'll be getting. Then simplifying on this, you'll be getting as E is going to be equals to taking common of Q D divided by 4 pi epsilon naught times R cube. Then the remaining part is of 2 cos theta AR plus sin theta of A theta. This equation you should keep in a box. I forgot to write here. Make this point. You should keep in a box. This is a very important equation for us. Then to obtain the plot of the potential field, choosing the dipole such that what is the thing we have to consider here? QD divided by 4 pi epsilon naught should be equals to 1. Then what is the equation? If this part is going to be 1, the is not in this case, here you have to substitute. Therefore, what is left? Cos theta is going to be equals to V into R square. Here it is written the same thing. Therefore, the figure is of shown here. This is what the dipole moment for electrostatics field. This is how we'll be getting. He observe here. In this case, it's not showing that it is of a positive or negative charge. Here we are telling that the two point charges are there. From that, we'll be getting the dipole like this. It is not known that which source and which is how it is going to be generating. That is what assumption we made here. That's why it is here written. We ask why the figure indicate the equipotential for which when our V is going to be equals to 0, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8 and plus 1. Here it is shown. 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. This is how it is. Potentials are going to be occurring. Then dipole axis is vertical. What it is shown with the positive charge on the top. Means a positive charges are in the top and negative charges are in the below side. Therefore, the streamlines means what the streamlines we taken of this path what it is taken, those things. The streamlines for the electric field are in a spherical coordination. If just we observe means it is not in a circular, it's a spherical. The path what it is going to be taken in any of the electric field, it will be in terms of a spherical. It depends how the things we will be going to be considering on that. In this case, it is of a spherical. ER by E theta is going to be what now? R into D theta divided by DR. That is nothing but sine theta divided by 2 cos theta. Therefore, DR by R, if I take, then it's going to be equals to 2 cot theta into D theta. This is simple maths, your trigonometry, you can know this. Therefore, R is going to be equals to what now? C1. A constant value, that is sine square of theta, you will be getting, where our C1 is the having the values of 1 for streamlines, the 1.5, 2 and 2.5 in this case. Okay, then about the potential field of the dipole may be simplified by using of the dipole moment, the same thing what is you already know. Let's first what you have to do, we should identify the vector length, how much it is there in between of 2 point charges, that is from minus 1 to Q2 plus Q, And as here it is, in this case we taken as D, yes, from the figure only we know. Then defining the dipole moment as Q into D and assigning the symbol, here the dipole moment is taken as small p, that is going to be equals to Q into D. This is what the equation for the dipole moment, you should know this. Then the unit of p is going to be coulomb per coulomb meter. It's not per, it's coulomb meter. Therefore D dot AR is going to be equals to D cos theta in this case. Therefore V is going to be what? P into AR divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square. Therefore if I simplify for this, I'll be adding an equation for V as 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, the same thing what is in the previously first module we take up, the same thing R minus R dash square into P. Instead of Q we are taking here as a P, dipole moment in terms of dipole moment, dot R minus R dash divided by mod of R minus R dash in with a specific vector. For that reason here it is mentioned as bar there. Therefore R locates the field point P and R dash determines the dipole where the center is of. This is what the R and R dash. And the equation, if you observe here, it is there any coordinate system which is going for? It's not that. Wherever the coordinate system is going to be in a dipole, you will be getting, it depends on the where the charge and what is the distance it is placed. That's what here it is telling. Means equation is independent of any coordinating systems. Then the dipole moment and the potential will not going to be changing as Q increases or D decreases, and providing the product is going to be equal to a constant van der Waals. Then the limiting case for the point dipole, what is the limitations are there, is achieved when D approaches to zero. Means point charges are that much near. When it is like that, if D is approaching zero and Q approaches infinity, such that the product of P, it's going to be a finite value. This is what the case we have to consider here. Then symmetrical arrangements of a larger number of points in the same way, if I'm going to taking different point charges, different locations at different points, if I am going to find the electric field intensity, in such cases I'm considering here as a symmetrical arrangements of larger number of point charges produce a field proportional to the inverse of the higher and higher powers of R. Means from the equation only, if I take this equation also, square of the distance, right? Here if I'm taking the inverse of the higher and higher, R square, R cube, R is to 4, 5, 6, it's going gone. In such cases, higher and higher powers of R, these charge distributions are going to be called as multipoles. Instead of single, means dipole, I can take, instead of two poles, I can go with the multipole, and they are in a infinite, used in infinite series to approximate more unwidely charged configuration. This is about a dipole. Dipole is placing a very important role when I'm going to learn a characteristics of any of the point charges. In the physics, we learned of some more importance of how it is going to be used. That application, what we learned in a basis, that we are applying here. That's it. This is about a dipole. Next, we'll move on to the next topic. This question may be asked for 6 marks or as for the 4 marks, depends on the question paper. Next is of our energy density in the electrostatic field. In the previous cases, whatever the things we taken, right, when a work it's going to be needed, when it is not needed, those things we learned. When we want a work has to be done, a point charge in an electric field, in an electric field is there. If I want to move a point charge from one place to the another place in opposite to the electric field direction, then I want the work has to be done to move the point charge from one place to the another place. But when electric field it is in this direction, It's just an example I'm giving here. Then a point charge, it is also moving in the same direction. Is there any work has to be done here? No, it will go as simple as in an electric field only. That's what the difference between where we want work has to be done, where it is not required the work here. That's what. Here is of only one point charge I am telling. Right? If in a field, a huge field, if there are many charges, negative charges are there, positive charges are there. Yes, positive charge here, in few more negative charges. Yes, in electric field, due to point charges, it is having on its electric field, and point charges are, it is in a random fashion, it's not in a particular direction. When you apply the potential, means when you apply the charge or a battery, then your current will flow. See, until unless it will be when your classes are engaging, until a professor will enter the class, you are like whatever things you want, you can doing of those things. The same thing how it is in the field, it is going far. When potential applied, all are arranging in one fashion, then a current will be flowing. Means what must the energy I have to give for this field, for this whole field, I will make with the what energy I should give for this field so that my field has to go in a one particular direction, or else a current has to flow from one path to the other path. What is that much? That's what here it is going for, energy density. Whatever things we taken here now, we are considering a limited number of point charges. For them, we have taken the equations. But here, in a density, in a large number, how it is going to be, the equations. Those things we are will be learning now. And one more thing, what example in this case it is taken here. If I am going to considering a vacuum, a point charge if I leave, only one point charge I am leaving here, means I am giving in a, placing in a vacuum. Means what it is going to be, if I place one point charge, it can move in a randomly anywhere it wants. Right? It can move anywhere. But when this is one case, after one point charge, I'll be placing one more point. It may be have positive or negative. It's not that it will be having a positive or negative. If I take one more point charge within the vacuum, what is the change it's going to be? If it is of like charges, it will be repelling. When it is of opposite charges, it will start attracting. There we want a work has to be done so that our point charge should be in a particular fashion, right? In such application, the same example here it is taken. If you can go through this, the same thing here it is there as a theory part. Next, we'll considering of the next. In order to find the potential energy present in a system of charges, we must has to find the work done by an external source in positioning the charges. Means what the work has to be done so that if it is of attracting, in which position they have to attract, means at what temperature, some consideration if I am going to be considering for that material, in which way it is going to be happening. That's what here it is taken. Then again we are going to be taking, we may start with the visualizing an empty universe, the same thing what I told, bringing their charge Q1 from infinity, from anywhere to the, at that point, infinity to any position requires a no work. Yes, it's not required, it will become and it will be placing. Therefore, there is no field is going to be presenting. The position of point 2, Q2, I am taking one more charge at their point in the field of Q1, requires, at this point, it is going to be requiring an amount of work given by the product of charge, that is Q2, and the potential at that point due to the Q1. What is that? Now we'll go for now. Next, this potential we can represent as how much the potential is required, that is V2, 1, where the first is going to be giving, indicates the location where it is there. And second is the from where it is taken, that is the source. The first one is indicating the location and second one is of the source. Therefore, V21 is the potential at the location of Q2 due to Q1. Just you remember this part. When I am writing V21 means the location Q2 due to Q1. At least if you remember this, this will be enough. When you are writing the problems, it will be helping for us for that reason. Therefore, what is the work is going to be? Work to position Q2. That is going to be equals to Q2 times of that potential V21. Next, similarly, in a different way, it means different point charges, if I am going to be considering, the work required to position each additional charge, if I am going to be adding the point charges in the field of the all those which are already present, then the work to position Q3 is going to be, observe here, Q3 V31 plus Q3 V32. Then work position at 4, that position where it is there, Q4 V41 plus Q4 V42 plus Q4 V43. For this, how you can analyze this, I just give a small example here. When you are starting off the engineering classes, you don't know anyone in the class. What you will be doing? You are the person, you will be sitting in one first bench. If I take in the benches like this, you will be sitting here. Then, after the second person, may sit here. Yes, it's not that he will be sitting beside you only, right? Then one more friend will come and sitting here, and one more friend will come and sitting here. Some friends are very much interested to write in sit in the last benches only, right? Now, what the distance what it is taken, the potential what it is going for. For from you, it is going to be considering. That's why it is a Q3. You are like a hero here. From hero, who are sitting in a different place. That's why it is taken. I hope you understood how the equations are written. Considering this, you as a reference point, from you, what are the potentials are going to be changing. Okay, that's what here it is written. Then the total work is going to be obtained. What is the work is done? Just by adding all the things, how many we are going to be positioning. Therefore, total positioning work is going to be equals to potential energy of the field. Observe here, total positioning means potential position work is going to be equals to potential energy of field. That is nothing but WE here it is going to be considered. Therefore, that is going to be equals to adding of all. Just go on adding of these to all. Q2 V21 plus Q3 V31 plus Q3 V32, then Q4 41, Q4 42, Q4 43, it's going on. Therefore, we can represent the equation as Q3 of V31 in terms of the equation, that is equals to Q3. We already know how it is going to be taken. That is going to be equals to Q1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught times R 13. Observe here, 3, 1. Here distance is going to be 13. That is also going to be equals to Q1 interchanging. Q3 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R31 means the distance what is going to be, it will be the same. Where R13 and R31 each represents a scalar distance between Q1 and Q3. Whereas Q3 to Q1, it will give the same values. For that reason, it is going to be, I can write like this. And equally well have been written in terms of a Q1. Instead of Q3, V31, I can write as Q1, V13 also. That's what here it is written. Then if each term of the total energy expression is replaced by its equal, if it is changing, instead of 31, if I write 13, therefore the equation is going to be WE is going to be equals to Q1 V1,2 plus Q1 V13 plus Q2 V23 plus Q1 V14 plus Q2 V24 then plus Q3 V34. Just you replaced here. For instead of 4, 3, 3, 4. instead of 4 to 2 4. The same thing here it is written here. That's it. Then comparing the two equations, then if I simplify here, therefore if I can add a 2, right, because it is having same potential and also got the same charge. For that reason, I can write here the equation as 2WE is going to be equals to Q1 of V12 plus V13, means from one position only it is differing. 3 plus V14 in the same way plus for Q2, means for if you are sitting here for from you, how the distance are away. And if I consider with a one more point charge, means other friend beside you, I can take from that what are the distance with the other point charge, means other students, where it is other friends, where it is takers sitting in the class. Q2 V21 plus V23 plus V24 then plus Q3 31 32 34 with the potentials, it's going on. Therefore, each sum of the potentials in the parenthesis what it's taken is combined potential due to all the charges except for the charge at the point where it is going to be considering, where this combined potential is being found, that V12, V13 plus V14 is going to be equals to V1 only. Therefore, the potential at the location of Q1 due to the presence of different point charges, Q2, Q3, Q4, how many friends are there in your class, you can make of that. Then WE is going to be equals to 1 by 2 Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus Q3 V3, it's going on. Then I can write in the general equation as 1 by 2 summation m is going to be equals to 1 to n, 1 to n qm v m. I can write it out. Simple things we are going for. Is there any difficult equations we are know? No, simple equations we are just solving out this. That's it. Now it is in terms of summation, but if I consider in a volume, what the equation we taken, it is for few point charges and general equation I wrote. Then next we will consider with that part. In order to obtain the expression for energy stored in the region of continuous charge distribution, what is the energy it is having? The energy storage means we will be preferring for capacitors only. That part we'll take in the consider next way. We'll learn of the energy stored in the region of continuous charge distribution, and each charge is going to be replaced with rho v into dv. This we know, q is going to be equals to rho v into dv. Therefore, instead of summation, it is going to be the integral. We is going to be equals to 1 by 2 integration with a volume rho v into v into with respect to dv only. Therefore, if I go with the equation of these two, allows us to find the total potential energy present in the system of point charges or distributed volume charge density. In the similar way, expression may be easily written in terms of a line or else in terms of a surface. What will be changing? Instead of rho v, rho l and rho s you have to change. Preferring this equation, to let it present all for the various types of charge which may be have to be considered, it depends actually. This may be also be done by considering the point charges, line charge density and also about the surface charge density as a continuous charge distribution of volume charge density over a very small regions. We can take of that. The going for that, we'll go with the what is the density equation it's going for. So using a Maxwell's first equation, replacing rho v by its equivalent, that's we know that del dot d, then use of vector identity, which is true for any scalar function v, then the where any vector function of d is going to be equals to del dot v d is going, it's perfectly equals to v del dot d plus d dot del of v. Then this may be proved readily, expansion in a Cartesian coordinate system. Therefore, we I can write here as 1 by 2 volume integral of rho v into v dv. I can write it as, instead of rho v, I can write as del dot d of v. Then writing the equation here of del dot d, 1 by 2 integration del dot v d minus d dot del of v into dv. This is based on using the divergence theorem, what we learned. The first volume integral of this part of the last equation is changed into the closed surface. Volume is going to be changing towards the closed surface, where the closed surface surrounds the volume considered. And this volume, first appearing the equation, what it is taken in our 43, must contain every charge, means for every charge it has to considering. Then there can be no charges outside the volume, means it will be including all the charges within that volume only. Then we can write the equation where for WE is going to be 1 by 2. Observe here the equation is changing as closed into surface integral V, VD, it's not dot del dot VD, it's of VD dot DS minus 1 by 2 volume integral in this part as it is, D dot del of V DV. Then the surface integral is going to be equals to 0. When it is going to be equals to 0? For over this closed surface surrounding the universe, we see that V is approaching to 0 at least as rapidly as 1 by R times. This is what 1 by R, the charge look like a point charge from there. From a distance, it's a like it's a seeing as a point charge. Therefore, D is approaching to 0, means this whole part is going to be 0 only. That's what here it is telling. As rapidly as the distance of 1 by R square. While the differential element of surface looking more and more like a portion of a sphere. Means from when a satellite is there in a space and you are person here sitting here, for that space you are like a negligible part of the, when I considering with the earth, the same thing here it is happening. The first part will be like a neglecting part when it's going to be taken. That's why it is telling the whole information. Therefore sphere, and is increasing only as R square. Therefore integrating, therefore it is going to be approaching to 0 with that distance, that is 1 by R. Therefore in the limit, the integrand and the integral are going to be equals to 0. Substituting E is nothing but minus del V, that what we know, that remaining volume integral, what it is will be getting that as VWE is going to be equals to 1 by 2 this part. D dot E, instead of del V, I can write here as minus of minus plus is going to be D dot E DV, that is nothing but, we know what is D, epsilon naught times E, that's you have to substitute here, 1 by 2 integral of volume, epsilon naught E square into DV. This is what the equation, the work has to be done when a charge is moving from infinite charge to the particular point. Next, the one more expression it's going for, to calculate the energy stored in the electrostatic field of a section of coaxial cable RLs in the capacitor of length L. Therefore, d rho is going to be equals to A into rho S divided by rho. Therefore, the equation I can write here as E instead of density in terms of electric field, that is equals to A rho S divided by epsilon naught rho into A rho, where A rho S is the surface charge density on the inner conductor whose radius is of A. Therefore, WE is going to be equals to 1 by 2 integration with a length 0 to L and with a angle rho pi rho pi z. There is a rho pi is going to be 0 to 2 pi and z is from A to B. That's what, just you substitute in this equation E square. Therefore, A square rho A square divided by epsilon naught square rho square into rho d pi dz. just you simplify, then you'll be reading as pi L A square rho square S divided by epsilon naught ln V by A. This result is obtained from the equation for what is already taken. Then choosing the outer conductor as our zero potential reference, then the potential of inner cylinder is going to be, if I am going to consider of the inner part only, then VA is going to be equals to minus integration B to A E rho D rho is going to be equals to minus integration B to A rho S divided by epsilon naught times rho D rho, that's the kind of thing, but A into rho S divided by epsilon naught ln B by A. Then the surface charge density rho S at rho is going to be equals to A can be interpreted as the volume charge density, that is rho V is going to be equals to rho S with respect to time T. Therefore, rho is going to be equals to A minus 1 by 2 of T to A rho is equals to A plus or minus of 1 by 2 of T, where T is very much less than A. Then the equation, what it is going to be reducing in a cylindrical. Therefore, the integration is therefore performed only within the thin cylindrical shell where rho is going to be equals to A, that is WE is going to be volume integral rho VV dV, that is going to be equals to 1 by 2. Limit will be changing here. Instead of A to B, it is going to be A minus T by 2, A plus T by 2, and rho S divided by T, A rho S divided by epsilon naught ln B by A. Rho d pi of dz. Therefore, WE is going to be equals to one volume for this, we'll be doing as A square, rho A square, ln B by A divided by epsilon naught pi into L. Therefore, this expression is more familiar form we recognize in a total charge on the inner conductor as Q is going to be equals to 2 pi A L into rho S. Then combining of the inner and outer of the cylinder, therefore WE is going to be equals to 1 by 2 Q VA. This is familiar with the energy stored in the capacitor, this equation. Therefore, the equation of where the energy is stored in the electric field has not yet been, still we not considered of that here, it is telling. The potential can be never be pinned down precisely in terms of physical location. It's not that where it is taken. That's like in the things what's taken. And is the energy stored in the molecules of the pencil, if I'm going to be taking in the gravitational field between the pencil and the earth. Means how it is taken. That's what here it is telling. What are factors in a different, how the charge is going to be. Those are things we have to consider here. Still we not got the answer, that's what here it is telling. Therefore, the electromagnetic field theory makes it easy to believe that it is giving just assumption. Or else you can consider of the point what it is explained till now. That is that energy of an electric field or a charge distribution is stored in the field itself. Therefore, in a expression what I can write here is WE is going to be 1 by 2. Integral of volume d dot e into dv, or I can write in a differential form that as d w e is going to be equals to 1 by 2 d dot e, that is dv, or else d w e divided by dv, that is going to be equals to 1 by 2 d dot e. This you have to remember the equation. What the value we got? 1 by 2 d dot e, which has a dimension of energy density, is going to be joules per cubic meter. This energy density over the entire field containing the volume, the result is truly the total energy present, but we have no more justification rather than of this part. That's what here it is telling. Whatever it may be, it depends on the persons who inventions are going on. Just you remember the equation. As per our knowledge, that will be enough. Okay, the next is explained about the volume. It's not required.